Hello everyone! You may have ever wondered how to make the motion graphics more attractive, but don't know what to do. One of those ways is to make a style for motion graphics. So in this video, I want to create a hand-drawn effect for my work to have a look better. And in the end, I want to have this kind of style. As you can see, the bushes have the pencil textures. This text is the same and we can also change it. And also the lines have a hand-drawn effect. And also I want to add a noisy effect to the scene, but this time I want to use textures for that. Before starting to work, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please subscribe, like and share this video with your friends. And if you have any questions, feel free to comment. Well, let's get to the job. I get into the comp. Firstly, for making a hand-drawn effect for these lines, I use the turbulent displace effect. I add it to the layer. I decrease its amount and set it to 10. And also decrease its size. I set it on 20. Then I should animate the evolution. So I alt-click on the stopwatch and type the time expression for it. Well, let's take a look at the animation and see how it is. Since I also want to add a slight distortion to the line, I duplicate this effect and increase its amount and set it on 30 and decrease the size and set it on 2. Well, let's have a look. Let me disable the first effect so I can fully see the second effect's impact. I make the background visible so it becomes more obvious. You see, I want something like this. After doing this, I unsolid the layers and paste these two effects for other lines in the scene. I also paste them for the stroke of the text. I do the same for the fill. I decrease the amount of the fill so it doesn't change so much. I set it on 3, but I increase the amount of the stroke so its shape differs from the fill text. I set it on 20 and move it to this side. And decrease this one. I move the stroke up a little. Okay, it's good. I copy these effects I made for clouds and paste them for the other objects. After that's done, I start making the texture comp, so that I can give a painting effect to the feel of the shapes. So for this, I have downloaded two textures. As you can see, the first one is this, and the second one is this. And with the help of these textures, I want to make a painting animation for the shapes. Well, I create a new composition, and set the resolution to 1000 by 1000 pixels. And set the duration to 1 second and click OK. I import these two textures into the comp. And I put the upper texture mode on the multiply, so the bottom texture to be seen too. I trim the layers on one frame. Then I duplicate the layers and bring them forward and change the angle. And I continue this process. I trim the work area here. I press Ctrl K so I can rename the comp. I name it Pencil. Then click OK. I go into the main comp and import the pencil comp to it. I put it above the bush layer because I want to give this layer a painting effect. I move the indicator to the beginning of the timeline so I can see the texture. I move the texture here to the same place that the bush is. I make it smaller. Then I choose the luma invert in the track matte option for the bush layer. As you can see, a painting texture has been created for the bush layer, but it's very subtle. Let me make it smaller. In order that pencil lines become more obvious, I add a levels effect to the texture, and I increase the contrast of the texture so the bush layer looks better. Now it's good. After that, I isolate this layer and the background layer so I can see how it is. As you can see, when I play, the comp after a few frames disappears. In order that the comp keeps going, I select the textures comp and I press Alt+Ctrl+C. I go to the frame before the last keyframe and create a keyframe for the time remap. After that, I Alt+click on its stopwatch and select the loop out expression for it, so that the animation of the comp keeps going till the end. As you can see, the comp animation changes in each frame. Well, it's good so far. I make the layers visible. I do the same for this bush too. If I want it different a little bit, I can rotate it. Well, I should do the same for the feel of the text. I played so I can see how the animation is. Well, it's good. Just I feel that if the stroke is a little to the left, it will be better. Now let's go for creating some noises for the scene by texture. To do this, I have downloaded a paper texture from onlygfx.com. And I want to use these stains on the paper as a noise for the scene. For doing so, I create a new composition. Name it to paper. And import the texture into it. I shrink it to fit the size of the comp. I go into the main composition. I import the paper comp into the main comp. Move it above the layers. I move the indicator to the beginning of the timeline to see the paper. And I enlarge it so it surrounds the whole scene. And for using these stains as noises, I go into the comp. And I make an adjustment layer. I add a tint effect to it so it becomes black and white. And then add a levels effect to increase the contrast, so that it becomes completely black and white, and it hasn't any gray points. Well, I go to the main comp, and here I select multiply. As you can see, the scene is noisy, but I think its opacity is too much, so I set it on 50. Good so far, but the noises are too big, that's why I should make them smaller. I go into the paper comp and make it smaller. For filling the blank parts, I use the reptile effect. I increase its amounts so the blank parts get filled. And for noises being random, I select turn CCW. As you can see, I have a small and better noises than before. I can also decrease its opacity and set it on 30. It's good for now. I go to the paper comp and start animating it. In the first frame, it should be like this. In the next frame, I duplicate it and move it here and rotate it 90 degrees. And I continue this process. Let's play and see how it is. It's good. I go to the main comp and I should loop the animation of the paper comp. That's why I select it and press Alt+Ctrl+T. One frame back and I create a keyframe for the time remap. Then I Alt+click on the stopwatch and I add a loop out expression for it. Well, let's see how the animation is. As you can see, the animation of the textures and effects changes in every frame, and it doesn't look good. That's why I add an adjustment layer, and I add the posterize time effect to the adjustment layer, and set the frame rate to 7 so that in every second 7 frames be shown. I play it again so I can see how the animation is. Well, as you see, its animation got better and it's more obvious, and I got almost what I want. I have a hand-drawn animation. Also, you can increase or decrease the frame rate of post-rise time so your animation becomes faster or slower. It depends on how you like it. And finally, because I did all the changes to the text layers, you can change the text without any problems. So before changing the text, I go into the motion curve stroke in the text and enable the expression of the source text. And I want to parent it to the source text of the motion curve fill so that when I change the fill text, the stroke changes too. And now you can type any text that you want. For example, I write my name. As you see, I simply wrote my name with the same style, and you can do it too. And finally, if you want to learn more about the shapes and features of this powerful tool in creating attractive motion graphics, so you can do your motion graphics very easily and quickly, I recommend you watch this course. And if you enroll with the link in the description, you will get it for half price.